Hi there, this is Caitlin Porter from the Mongoose Enablement Team. Welcome to part two of the Mongoose Hello World training series. In this video, we'll be going over the Mongoose IDO capabilities and introduce the inheritance model. So, what exactly is the inheritance model? Mongoose provides the capabilities to create classes that hold properties, characteristics, and attributes that can be reused. This allows for a single point of maintenance for the fundamental data types. With proper planning, this can create a much more efficient and consistent application. There are many levels at which you can inherit these classes, and they can be overwritten at various levels. This model allows us to inherit a base class and refine it, keeping our refinements exclusive to a specific level. In today's video, we will dive deeper into this using the inheritance model within our application. In part one, we created a customer's form, a customer's table, and a customer's IDO, which provided access to the table. On that IDO, we created a property called ID and assigned it a length of 50. To view the attributes of that field, let's open the customer form in design mode. Click the design mode icon from the toolbar to open up the designer in a separate tab. If this is the first time you've entered design mode, you will be asked to identify your editing scope. For this demo, we will always be developing at the site default level. Select site default and hit OK. Let's open our customer's form from the menu, and you should see it in the list of recently used forms. Select the ID edit component that is bound to our ID property. We would expect this to have a length of 50. Expand the data source section from the properties panel on the right, and you can see that the component is bound to the ID property on our IDO. Once you expand data type, you can see that the length is listed as 0. Now, if you scroll down to the inheritance section, click the ellipsis to view the attributes inherited from the property. Here, you should be able to see your length of 50 that is being inherited from the property. The 0 that we saw earlier was the length that was defined at the component level. If we wanted to, we could define a length of, say, 200 here, and would override the length of 50 assigned at the property level without changing the property definition. Instead of changing this at the component level, let's create a property class that we can use as a foundation to build other property classes. The best practice is to use property classes whenever possible, and that involves some proper planning of your data model. Because property classes are metadata, it's simple to adjust them as you develop. Navigate back to the Runtime Mode tab, and let's create a new Explorer shortcut. Right-click on My Folders and create New Shortcut. Search for Property Classes, and select the IDO Property Classes form. Expand your My Folders, and double-click your property classes to open the property classes form. After the form opens, hit the filter in place icon, and then new to add a new property class. Go ahead and shrink the Explorer to give us a little more real estate. Name our property class UMBase, short for unit of measure. Give it a data type of string and a length of 10. Drop the column data type list. By default, this will only query the first 200 items. Rather than scrolling through this list looking for what we want, we should use the in-place filtering. Type in nvar and use the wildcard, which is an asterisk, and then hit the arrow. By typing this, it will only query the items in the list that start with nvar. We can do this even quicker by typing nvar and hitting the F2 key. Doing this will imply there is an asterisk. Select nvarchar for our column data type and give it a label string ID of SUM. Then hit save. For efficiency, Mongoose has caching of metadata at both the app server and the client. To be sure our new property class shows up as available, close the form and unload all the global form objects by selecting Form, Definition, Unload All Global Form Objects. The next thing we should do is build the pieces to enable us to designate a unit of measure for an item in our app. For example, we want to have the option to say these eggs are X dollars a dozen, or that these bikes are X dollars each. Navigate back to the Design Mode tab and click the New Form Definition icon from the toolbar. The category, select New Data, and for the wizard, select Maintenance. Hit OK, and this will launch the new Data Maintenance wizard. Go ahead and give our IDO a name of UMs. Let's use our Hello World project and give it a table alias of UMS. I want to add a property below. Type in UM for the name, and find your UMBase property class that we just created. Once you select the class, you will see that it automatically sets the data type, length, and label string because it is inheriting that from the property class. Set this property to be the primary key and make it required. Add another row, name this one description, give it a data type of string, a length of 50, and set the label string ID to S description. Like next, and then finish, and select yes when it asks you if you want to create a form. Once the new form wizard opens, hit next, accepting the defaults. Here you can specify what properties you want to include on your form. Let's leave the defaults and hit next. Here, you can reposition fields on your form by using the arrows on the right. I'm going to move my UM field to the top. Once you're done positioning your fields, hit next and finish to create your form. Once the form opens in design mode, you'll notice that our UM string is being inherited from our property class. If you were to change the string value on the UM base property class, that change would cascade down to our UM's form. Since it's a new string, we'll need to create it. Click on the label component, and on the caption field to the right, click the ellipsis. Give it a string value of unit of measure, hit OK, and hit save. Jump back to the runtime mode tab, and let's open our new form. Notice now that our label is showing the correct string value that we just created. The form will automatically open in add mode. Let's add two records, the first being EA, description of each, and the second being DZ, description of dozen. Hit save from the toolbar. We're now going to create another property class that will use our UM's IDO to pull a list of the unit of measures that are available in our UM's table. Open our IDO property classes form, and let's create a new property class called UM. Let's use our UM base for the base class, which will inherit the data type, length, and label string ID value. Any of those attributes that are being inherited from the base class can be overwritten here. To give it a list source, go to the domain IDO field and select our UM IDO. For the domain property, select UM, and for additional list properties, select description. Notice the asterisk next to the domain fields. This indicates that we are overriding the inherited attributes. Let's create two more property classes that we can use in our application. Hit the new icon from the toolbar, and let's name our first class item base. Give it a data type of string, a length of 20, select the column data to nvarchar, and give it a label string ID of sItem. Add another row, and let's name this one cost, give it a data type of decimal, a length of 18, a decimal precision of 2, a default value of 0, decimal for the column data type, and a label string ID of sCost. Hit save, and let's clear the cache, close the form, and select form, definition, unload all global form objects. Now we want to create our items table, IDO, and form. Let's go back to the design mode tab and click the new form definition icon. Select new data for the category and maintenance for the wizard. Click OK to launch the new data maintenance wizard. Let's name this items and place it in our Hello World IDO project. Give it a table alias of ITMS. Let's add some properties. Hit the add row button and let's add one called item. Let's select our item-based property class that we just created. This should inherit the data type, the length, the column data type, as well as the label string ID. Let's make this property the primary key, as well as required. Let's add another property. Hit the add row button, and let's name this one description. Give it a data type of string, a length of 150, and a label string ID of sDescription. Hit the add row button to add another property. Let's name this one cost. Let's use our cost property class that we just created, and you can see it will inherit all the attributes included in that property class. Let's add one more property. Let's name this one UM, and let's assign it our UM property class that we previously created. Hit next and finish, and select yes when it asks you if you want to create a form. Now the new form wizard will open. Let's accept the defaults and hit next. Let's leave the properties that it defaulted to and hit next. I want to rearrange the properties on my form. To do so, I'm going to move the item to the top and the description just under that. Once I'm done with that, I'm going to hit next and finish to create my form. Once the form opens, you'll notice that the item and cost strings need to be created. I'm going to go ahead and click on the components, select the ellipsis from the caption field, and give them both a string value. Once I'm done with that, I'm going to save my form. Let's go back to the Runtime Mode tab and open our newly created Items form. Notice that Mongoose has created a combo box component bound to the UM property instead of an edit. This is because we have inherited domain information which Mongoose uses to provide a list source for the component. Try creating a new entry with an invalid unit of measure. When you go to save your record, you should get an error message saying that you selected an invalid item. This is because we use a property class that has a domain IDO list, which has built-in validation to make sure the user selects an item from the list source. List sources and validations are more examples of runtime inheritance at work. We could go all the way back to the property class level and add additional units of measure or modify our existing two, and the form will automatically update. You can also notice that our cost property is inheriting the decimal data type with a default value of 0. What did we just build? Let's take a quick look. We began by creating the property class UMBase, where we assigned the label string ID SUM. Then we created another property class named UM, which was derived from UMBase, which means it inherited the label string ID SUM. On this level, we added the IDO domain information, which allowed us to have a drop list of items and validation from the UM's table. Next, we created the property UM, which was derived from UMBase, meaning that again, the label string ID SUM was inherited. After our UM's form was created, an edit component that was bound to the UM property inherited that same label string ID. Before we finish up, let's add some data to our items table. Switch back to runtime mode and add three more entries. The first being dumbbell with a description of 45 pound iron, a cost of $45, and a unit of measure of EA. Add another row, this time name it guitar, with a description of natural acoustic, costs $129.99, and a unit of measure of EA. Add one more record, this time name it eggs, with a description of cage-free, a cost of $6.99, and unit of measure DZ. Once you're done adding your four records, hit save. In part three, we'll be exploring querying and take our first look at the event system. For more tutorials and documentation, check out the Mongoose portal at mongoose.infor.com. Thanks for watching.